We get discussing about relief, tax relief. Under Section 89, tax relief under Section 89. So here, if you receive any advance salary, or if you receive any arrear salary, if you receive any advance salary, or if you receive any arrear salary, then we get here a relief, because it is a slab based structure is there. Income tax, as you have seen in the first chapter, we have slab on first 2,50,000 is nil. Likewise, so if you receive any arrear salary, past year's arrears, then your tax slab increases. In the sense, if you are in 20% bracket, you shift to 30% bracket. Therefore, we provide relief. So similarly, here Section 89, read with Rule 21A, grants relief to the assessee who receives salary being paid in arrears or in advance, your salary for more than 12 months in any one financial year, or profits in lieu of salary is received, or family pension has been received, and the same is being paid in arrears, where due to which the total income of the assessee is assessed at a higher rate than the rate at which it would have been assessed, because you are receiving one lump sum amount together, therefore we are providing the relief. Now, this is a basic fundamental thing, is how you will be computing the relief if you receive any advance or arrear salary. The arrear salary or advance salary, if you receive that, that is termed as the additional salary. There is additional salary. This is basically additional salary. So here the admissible relief, the same will be calculated as per the following steps. First of all, calculate the tax payable on the total income. Calculate the tax payable on total income, including the additional salary of the previous year in which the same is received. Calculate the tax payable on the total income. Calculate what the tax payable on the total income, including the additional salary of the previous year in which the same is received. We'll be calculating the same. Then calculate the tax payable on total income, excluding the additional salary of the previous year in which the same is received. Say, in previous year, 20XXXY, we have received total income of, say, rupees 20 lakhs, out of which 8 lakhs is the arrear. So first of all, what we'll be calculating, we'll be calculating tax on 20 lakh rupees. We'll be calculating tax on 20 lakh rupees, including the additional salary. Then we'll be calculating tax on what? 12 lakh rupees. That is what? Excluding the additional salary. And we'll find out the difference between tax at step 1 and 2. We'll find out this difference. That is step 3. Then say this 8 lakh relates to, say, 20XUXY, 2 years back it relates. Then we'll be calculating the tax, we'll be calculating the tax on the total income after including the additional salary in the previous year to which such salary relates. So this 8 lakh rupees, earlier we have received, say, 8 lakh 50,000 at that time. So we will be adding this 8 lakh rupees, and we will be calculating tax on what? 16 lakh 50,000 rupees at the applicable tax rates of that assessment year. To the assessment year to which it relates, or to the previous year to which it relates, we will be calculating the tax on the same. Then we will be finding out the tax excluding the additional salary. That is, on 8,50,000, we will be finding out the tax, and we will be finding out the difference of these tax. Then this is step 6. So difference relief will under 89 will be what? Tax which has been computed at step 3 minus tax computed at step 6. So when we will be discussing the practical question, it will be clear to you. So here this relief is provided. However, we have also discussed that if you are claiming VRS compensation exemption, if VRS compensation exemption is claimed, then no relief under Section 89 will be available. So here, no relief shall be granted under this section, that is under Section 89, in respect of any amount which is received or received by an assessee on his voluntary retirement or voluntary termination of his service. He won't be getting the benefit of the relief. If he claims exemption under Section 1010C in respect of such or any other assessment year, then he won't be getting the relief. So the cumulative effect of 1010C and 89 is the assessee cannot avail of exemption under 1010C and simultaneously claim relief under 89 in respect of exempt income in the same assessment year. Besides this, once an exemption is claimed under 1010C, then no exemption under 1010C and no relief under 89 can be claimed for any other assessment year also. And once relief under 89 has been claimed, then for any other in respect of VRS compensation, no exemption under 1010C can be availed for any other assessment year. However, if any VRS compensation is received subsequently from any other employer, relief can be what? Claimed under 89. Therefore, relief can be claimed under 89 more than once. So, once a relief has been claimed under 89 in respect of VRS compensation received, no exemption under 1010C can be claimed for any other assessment year. However, if any VRS compensation is received subsequently from any other employer, if VRS compensation received from any other employer, then relief under 89 can be claimed subsequently from the other employer. Thus, relief under 89 can be claimed more than once here. Now, we are discussing one question. Mr. Ashok Kumar, an employee of PSU, furnishes the following particulars. He is saying the salary income for the year is 8,25,000. For the year is 8,25,000. Salary for financial year 9-10 is received during the year to 40,000 rupees. Then assessed income of financial year has also been provided. So here we'll be computing the tax. First we'll be computing tax on 8,65,000 rupees, including the arrear salary. So step one will be what? Computation of tax on rupees 8,65,000. AY 21-22, that is including additional salary. So what is the amount of tax on 8,65,000? So it is on 2,50,000 is nil. On next 2,50,000, it is what? 5%. Next, you know, how much is this? 365. It is 20%. So it works out to be how much? 73,000. So it is 75,500. This is tax. Add HEC at rate of 4%. 3020. So it works out to be how much? 7,8. it is 12,500, not 2,500. So it is a calculation. Please check that. It is how much? 85,500. And 4% of 85,500. 3,420. It is 88,920. So in step one, we are calculating the tax. That is what? 88,920. Step two is what? Compute the tax. Compute the tax on total income. Excluding additional salary. For AY 2021. So it is what? Tax on rupees 8,25,000. Which works out to be how much? 8,25,000, 250 it is nil. Next 250 it is 5%. That is 12,500. Then it is 5 lakh, then 325. It is 20%. So it is 325 into 20%. 65,000. Total works out to be 77,500 into 4%. 77,500 into 4%, 3,100. That is 80,600. It is 80,600. Step 3 is what? We have to find out the difference. Find out the difference at 1 and 2. What is the difference between 1 and 2? That is 8,320. Step 3. Then step 4 is calculate the tax on total income, including additional salary of the previous year to which it relates. Here it relates to assessment year 10-11, financial year 9-10. 140 was that year's income, plus 40,000 is arrears, so it is 1,80,000. So here on first 1 lakh it is nil, then next 40,000 it is 10%, means 4,000 rupees. And there was at that time education cess of 2%. So 4,000 means 40. For 1 lakh it is nil. Then for next 50,000 it is 10%. 180 we have to calculate now. 50,000 it is 10%, that is 5,000. Then next, additionally, we have got 30,000 rupees, it is 20%, 6,000. So it is 11,220 rupees. Tax applicable rate is this. Then step 5 is what? We will calculate the tax on total income, excluding the additional salary to the previous year to which it relates. Here it will be 1,40,000. On 1,40,000, it will be 4080. 4080. This is fifth step. Step six is what? We'll be finding out difference between 4 and 5. Finding out the difference between 4 and 5. That is how much? 11,220 minus 4080. 7140 is the difference. Relief is what? Tax at step 3 minus step 6. So, how much it will be? 8320 minus 7140. 8320 minus 7140. So, the relief will be how much? 8320 minus 7140. That is 1180 is the relief. And the tax payable works out to be how much? 88,290 was our liability. 88,920 was our tax liability, and we have provided relief of 1180. 88,920 minus what? 1180. That is 87,740 is our tax liability. 87,740 is the tax liability. So this way we have computed the amount of the relief under section 89. So first step is what? We'll be computing the tax on the total income. We'll be computing the tax on the total income including the additional salary in year in which it is received. Then we'll be computing the tax on the total income excluding the additional salary in the year in which it is received. Then we'll be finding out the difference between the tax at step 1 and 2. Then in step 4, we'll be computing the tax on the total income including the additional salary of the previous year to which it relates. Here it relates to financial year 9-10. Therefore, we have added the same in financial year 9-10. Then step 5, we'll be calculating the tax on the total income excluding the additional salary of the previous year to which it relates. Then we'll be finding out the difference between taxes step 4 and 5. That's step 6. And relief admissible is step 3 minus step 6. That is the relief which is admissible. So this way, we'll be calculating the relief under section 89.